I'll just go ahead and say it out of the gate. I'm a Kalugo bro, Kalubro of sorts. I've basically been on board with the Kalugo compact stroller since the original model came out several years ago. What hooked me was how easy it was to open and close the stroller and how easy it was to store given its compact size. So in this video, I'm going to review the second generation Kalugo compact stroller and let you know if it continues to meet my expectations, plus compare a couple of features to another extremely popular compact stroller, the Upa Baby Menu. So don't Kalugo anywhere. So like I mentioned, this stroller is the second version of the quite popular compact stroller that came out on the market a couple of years ago. The size and design and the overall aesthetic of the V2 model is fairly similar to the V1 model, but there are some noticeable upgrades to mention. But first, let's talk about the price. The Kalugo compact stroller runs around $295, and as a bonus, they offer a 100-day money-back guarantee. So if it's a Kalugo no-go at any point during the 100-day trial, you can return the stroller, including free shipping, and get a full refund, so pretty sweet. Just a quick note that if you are interested in purchasing the stroller or any of the other strollers I mentioned, there are affiliate links in the description below for your convenience. Clicking on those links helps support this channel at absolutely no cost to you, so if you like what we do, please consider clicking those links. Our children's college funds will thank you. All right, let's get back to the features. So as an added bonus, it comes with a rain cover, a cup holder, and a travel bag. And I believe there aren't a whole lot of other stroller companies that offer those kind of accessories for free. Plus, there are a bevy of color schemes to choose from, and there's even a Bella Twins edition for you WWE fanatics out there.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
So the thing I love the most about the stroller is how compact it is and how easy it is to open and close. In fact, they say it's a one-hand, 2-second open and close, and actually it's quite literally that. I basically feel like a magician every time I do it. So to achieve the one-handed 2-second fold operation, just squeeze the trigger in the middle of the handlebar and push down, and bam, stroller closed. To open the stroller, undo the clasp on the side of the stroller and yank upwards. It's easy as that. Now I just recently picked up the Upa Baby Menu stroller, which is basically the more posh version of the Kalugo. And I've been going over its features with a fine-tooth comb. So in a very soon-to-be-released video, I'll do a more in-depth feature-to-feature comparison of the Kalugo compact stroller and the Upa Baby Menu. So be sure to subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you can brag to your friends that you were the first person to catch the review. It's every dad's dream, I'm sure. So the Upa Baby Menu also has a one-handed closing mechanism, but in my opinion, the Kalugo's one-handed close is much easier to accomplish because you just basically have to squeeze the closing mechanism. Whereas with the Menu, you've got to kind of push it in with your thumb and then squeeze the trigger. I mean, outwardly, it doesn't seem like a huge difference, but once you've done it a couple times, you'll really notice it. So not only is the Kalugo easy to open and close, but as the name implies, it's super compact when folded. It also has a carry strap, which makes it easy to carry around when not in use. Plus, it's only 16 pounds, so if you are carrying it, it won't be all that burdensome. The canopy is rated UPF 50+, and it can be extended even further by unzipping the back of the canopy. There's also a peekaboo flap at the top of the canopy to look down into the seat. The seat itself can be reclined to a nearly 180-degree angle by loosening the straps situated at the back of the seat. To raise the seat back up, simply pull on the straps and you're good to go. You can also adjust the angle of the leg rest by pushing on a couple of buttons, which helps the seat achieve that nearly lie-flat position. The seat has a maximum weight limit of 55 pounds, which is on the higher end as far as compact strollers go, but it's highly recommended that your baby not ride in the stroller until they're about 6 months old. However, there is an infant insert option you can buy for $95 as an accessory online if you want to use this as a newborn stroller. I do have a bit of an issue with the depth of the seat though. At only 6 inches, it's a little shallow for me, which I guess is one of the trade-offs of going smaller versus going with a standard everyday-like stroller. That said, if you compare the seat to the Upa Baby Menu, which also is a compact stroller, as I mentioned, and also has the one-hand fold system, like I also mentioned, then you'll notice quite a difference in size. And the Menu has a depth of 9 inches, and is also an inch wider at 13.5 inches. And compared this to Kalugo's 12.5-inch wide seat, and like I mentioned, the 6-inch depth of the seat. So a bit of a difference there. And I also have leggy kids, and you know, one of them has a lot of junk in the trunk, if you will. So his little booty has a hard time at times staying right in the middle of that seat. So just something I thought I'd mention for you folks out there with kids on the larger end of the size spectrum. When it comes to strapping your little one to the seat, the Kalugo utilizes a 5-point magnetic harness system. Now for me, it was a bit tricky at first to get a handle on how the harness mechanism worked. You've got to kind of connect the two strap harness components together first, and then with your other hand, attach the, you know, for lack of a better word, crotch component to these strap components. Now, if you're a new parent, then you'll quickly come to find just how efficient children are at making things dirty, especially items like car seats and strollers. So it's just a matter of time before that happens, but when it does, the seat cover is fully removable and 100% washable, if that makes sense, and 100% wipeable, if that also makes sense. Basically, if the seat gets dirty, you'll quickly be able to get it clean again. Now, underneath the seat, you'll find a decently sized cargo area, but considering the compact stroller size, it's not all that surprising. What is a little surprising is that it has a 10-pound weight limit, which is not a lot, especially if you compare it to the Up a Baby menu, like I've been doing, which has a max weight limit of 20 pounds. The Kalugo rides on a set of non-puncture tires, meaning they don't need to be inflated and are super durable. Now, between the back tires is the foot brake, and to engage the brake, you just simply push down on the pedal. Pretty simple. I do want to note that we've heard from some of our taller viewers that because the handlebar isn't adjustable, they have to stand rather close to the stroller, which at times would result in them either kicking the wheels or even the brake at times. So just something to be aware of, but there's a positive aspect to the handlebar being closer to the body of the stroller, in that it won't tip backwards very easily if you've got a diaper bag or a backpack strapped to the handlebars. So who is the Kalugo Compact for? I'd say it's really for anyone looking to save space, but do it in style. If you live in a big city and are often navigating subways or taxis, or even traversing up and down stairs all day, the Kalugo is going to be a great option. Mainly, again, because it's super easy to open and close, and it's extremely lightweight. The $295 price tag is fairly moderate considering it comes with a lot of freebies like the rain cover, the cup holder, the backpack, and especially if you compare it to strollers like the Up a Baby, which will run you around $400 and doesn't come with any of those kinds of accessories. Plus, you've got the 100 days to try it out and get your money back if you decide it's a, I'm gonna say it again, a Kalugo no-go. That's a great pun. So speaking of trying things out and getting your money back if you don't like it, you should definitely try out our course for new and expecting dads called Father's Ed. It's a super in-depth course chock full of information that will guide you through everything you need to know on how to care for your baby, how to be a supportive father, how to be a supportive partner, what kind of gear you need, what kind of gear you don't need, and other super important topics. Plus, it comes with a super sexy workbook if you like learning the old-fashioned way. Actually, got one right here. Pretty sexy, right? I mean, that's not me, but I imagine I'd look pretty good on that cover too. This thing is great. It's, you know, 80 pages or so, and it's just basically everything in the videos, all the important topics and, you know, the bullets that we go over, but in workbook form, which is, you know, I think pretty great. I've been swimming in raw sewage. I love it. You're gonna have to learn to love it. Anyway, so check it out, fathercraft.com/fathersed. That's fathercraft.com/fathersed. Like I said, be sure to come back for our upcoming reviews. We've got quite a few of them. Like I mentioned, the Up a Baby menu, there'll be a standalone review, plus that comparison review with the Kalugo, plus another Love Every review, which will be fun. All kinds of stuff coming up in the hopper. So again, please be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you can watch those videos as they come out. All right, people, thanks again. I will see you in the next video.